Good morning, Life Spring. Today we are in Psalm 10. Psalm 10, let's look at verse 1. Why, Lord, do you stand far off? Why do you hide yourself in times of trouble? I'm sure that is a question that a lot of us could be asking right now. God, in the midst of this coronavirus crisis, in the midst of my situation right now, where are you, God? Where are you? And the psalmist goes on, and he essentially paints the picture of a wicked man prospering in times of trouble, and he being a faithful person is left asking, God, where are you in the midst of my persecution? And though our troubles might not be the same as the psalmist here, still it's a question that we have to ask ourselves. God, where are you? Where are you? My situation is painful. My way of living is hard. But these questions are just questions that we need to do our best to resist throughout our day. Why? Because God is good. God is good. Look at verse 12. Arise, Lord. Lift up your hand, O God. Do not forget the helpless. Why does the wicked man revile God? Why does he say to himself, he won't call me to account? But you, God, see the trouble of the afflicted. You consider their grief and take it in hand. The victims commit themselves to you. You are the helper of the fatherless. Break the arm of the wicked man. Call the evildoer to account for his wickedness that would not otherwise be found out. The Lord is king forever and ever. The nations will perish from his land. You, Lord, hear the desire of the afflicted. You encourage them and you listen to their cry, defending the fatherless and the oppressed so that the earthly mortals will never again strike terror. So the second half of this psalm, it shows us the man who never really gets the why to his question answered. The question is never really answered, where is God? Why is God not there? Yet this person trusts God completely. And while we might not have that peace, we might not have that rest, we might not have that refuge until a future day, we can still have God's promises present in our life today. We can still see a God who is reigning supreme in heaven above. We can still see a God who loves the helpless, who loves the grief-stricken, who loves the oppressed, so much so that he literally left his position of power, he left his throne to come to walk our life, to live our life, to be oppressed, to be judged, to be grief-stricken, to be nailed to a cross for us. God, we love you, and we don't always know why. It doesn't feel like you're present in our circumstances, but that does not mean that you are not with us. And we love that you loved us so much that you came and you've walked through everything that we are walking through now and more. And we can take rest and we can take refuge in knowing that you have not only lived our life, but that you have overcome sin, sickness, death, and the grave. And we love you so much, God, and we take rest and refuge in you. Amen.